Hello and welcome to another audio analysis. In today's video, we'll be taking a look at the track Somebody's Watching Me by the American musician Rockwell. Given it is the 31st of October, it seems only fitting to take a look at a true Halloween classic, and whilst there are plenty of them such as Thriller, Ghostbusters and a variety of others, some of them don't really have the rich history that this track certainly does. So will this track be worth keeping an eye on or simply avert your gaze? Let's take a look at exactly how it sounds.
I'm just an average man with an average life. I work from 9 to 5. Hey, hell, I pay the price.
So before we dive into the track, I want to talk about his stage name, Rockwell. He actually gave himself that name because he rocks well. It's as simple and as easy as that, but you're probably wondering why he used that stage name at all. It's actually because he was the son of Motown founder Berry Gordy, and he actually didn't have the best relationship with his father. He wouldn't actually be able to get onto the label to start with, despite showing his father the early recordings of this track before it had been adapted slightly, and he didn't kind of feel it was up to the same standard. So they actually kind of had this disparity between the two, which would be fixed later in life or after the release of this track when it became a global phenomenon, but he was actually just trying to kind of hide himself and not really show that link with his father. And it's really interesting because even in the first verse, I'm just an average man with an average life, he was the complete opposite. He was very, very rich. He was very well looked after. I mean, he got to hang with Michael Jackson and all the rest of the Jacksons, Jermaine and the rest of them, and he didn't exactly live like he was kind of on the breadcrumb line almost. He wasn't kind of fighting over the scraps of the table. So he kind of tried to put these lyrics in and this name to really show him and make him feel like he was more of a common person, certainly. And he did also throw a lot of other instances into the actual lyrics as well. I love the line, "But why do I always feel like I'm in the Twilight Zone?" It's actually inspired by a program that was on CBS from 59 to 65, dealing with bizarre and abnormal situations. So really just fitting in a couple of things that kind of show the idea of this abnormality. And in the music video as well, you can really see that coming in. And the song itself was actually quite heavily inspired by his childhood, just watching out the window as a kid and just people looking up into his windows and things like that, looking into people's houses, being quite nosy, and that he kind of drew inspiration from that to kind of put the track together. And then getting Michael Jackson into the actual chorus, well, despite not being credited on this song, it just really adds a lot of power and a lot of hook to the chorus. I mean, you've got one of the biggest stars of the world pretty much kind of singing on your song, and you were at the time he was an unknown artist, and it was the reason that he was able to shoot to this stardom. But this idea of always feeling like you're being watched, it's almost a song that's aged very well with the rise of technology, the idea that you're always being watched by cameras and things like that. So it ultimately has kind of been aided by that as well, because it's a song that feels more real, despite initially just being based on just almost Norsey Parkers, effectively.
When I come home at night, I put the door real tight. People call me on the phone I'm trying to avoid. Okay, the people on TV see me, or am I just paranoid? I'm afraid to wash my hair, 'cause I might open my eyes and find someone standing there. People say I'm crazy, just a little touched, but maybe showers remind me of psycho humor. That's why
I always feel like somebody's watching me, and I have no privacy. Oh, I always feel like somebody's watching me, who's playing tricks on me.
So as we move into the second verse, we actually get a couple of really interesting lyrics. When I'm in the shower, I'm afraid to wash my hair because I might open my eyes and find someone standing there. He actually used to play tricks and pranks on his girlfriend at the time and would just rock up at the shower when she was showering and just kind of scare her on the glass or just really kind of play these little tricks on her. And then also referencing in the idea of the Alfred Hitchcock movie Psycho and just really kind of blending that into the actual lyrics as well. So really kind of making it much easier to kind of fit in with these visuals that many people will have either seen or be aware of. And just again, just really going into that chorus, just the beautiful blending between Michael Jackson and Rockwell. He actually initially took a boombox over to the Jackson's house and he played it about 8 or 9 times, and Michael would just gradually draw people down. And eventually, after these 8 or 9 times of playing it and singing along to the actual music, he actually pulled him aside and said, look, who are you going to get to do the backing vocals? And he said, well, can you do it? And he just was like, okay, I'll do it. So him and Jermaine both ended up getting involved, and again, just really just showing how it's aided in becoming one of the most successful tracks and a Halloween staple at that, really aided by the video and this idea of just building this paranoia in, which is something that really fits in with that Halloween theme, the idea of monsters under the bed and things like that. So it's ultimately tied itself in and dug its roots quite heavily into different things that have enabled it to become a classic, almost a timeless classic. Yes, it certainly is just one of those timeless classics, a song that just never seems to get old, possibly aided by the fact that it does feature Michael Jackson, and his vocals and his sounds have never really just worn away. They remain iconic, as iconic today as they were when they initially released many of his tracks over the 70s and the 80s, but it really just captures beautifully that idea of this paranoia, making use of these almost organ sounds, really building in almost this kind of Dracula-esque atmosphere that it really includes, as well as kind of tying it in with the music video as well. Just many of the elements really help to build that. I almost don't really understand why he goes for this almost fake British accent that he tries to throw in, but it's just another little quirky thing that really makes the track have that bit more of a fun edge and again helps to make it stand out. We do get some other verses that are almost futuresque as well. I wonder who's watching me now, who the IRS. You often see stories of celebrities kind of avoiding paying taxes and things like that. So again, this idea of all eyes being on you. So again, another factor that's really enabled this song to kind of be more timeless, because it's kind of only strengthened as time has gone on. And obviously having a powerhouse like Michael Jackson really joining you when you're an unsigned artist, someone that became effectively one of Motown's biggest stars and a global phenomenon, really kind of helps push you forward. And it would be the start that he needed to really get his career going, and it would allow him to kind of repair the fractured relationship with his father, who would begin to accept him, and he would go on to release some other music. He would cover things such as the Beatles' Taxman and a variety of other tracks as well, as well as producing his own, but none of them were quite able to live up to the hype that this one did achieve, and certainly the longevity as well. But it's great that it remains a Halloween classic that always gets played, always around this time of year. But it's one of those songs that isn't just tied to Halloween. It is one of those songs that can be played all year round, and it doesn't always have to be kind of shoehorned into that one particular style. So that will be everything for today's video, but as always, feel free to let me know your thoughts about this track in the comments section below. Do you agree that it is a timeless classic, or are you absolutely sick to death of hearing it? Do you think it's just a little bit too silly? I would love to know your thoughts. Also, if you'd like to see more content like this, then please do feel free to subscribe, and I will see you in the next Dojo Analysis.